Hello friends, do you know temperature is the most monitored and controlled parameter in any process industries and responsible product quality, be it a petroleum product, cement, cosmetics, every product you manufacture. Almost all chemical reactions perform under the close control of temperature. You might have attended thousands of problems related to temperature not being correct or need frequent replacement of sensor. Selection and installation of the same is again a big task. Friends, today we will discuss about temperature sensor office and various selection and installation techniques. Mainly, there are two types of measurement techniques. First one is contact type and another one is non-contact type. Because 80% contact type application is used in process industry, so we will discuss about it only. In this technique, the sensor is inserted directly in the process and comes in direct contact with heating media such as liquid or gas. And heat is transferred to the sensor through heat conduction process and hence temperature is measured. In contact type application, there are two types of sensor widely used. First one is RTD, also commercially called PT100. Its sensing element is of platinum, as the name suggests, and its sensing element can be of nickel or copper also. Second one is thermocouple. It can also be of many types like J, K, RS, T. They all have different temperature ranges accordingly. Let's first discuss selection procedures. What are the main criteria to select a temperature sensor for right application? Of course, range of sensor comes first. How much your temperature in target is varied. It decides the range. If temperature is 200 or 500, then RTD is best suited. Now it comes 2-wire, 3-wire type. Singles, duplex. If the application is critical, then you need to select duplex to reduce downtime and 3-wire for auto compensation. Thermocouple from 300 to 1200 is fine. It is a wide range. By selecting type of thermocouple, you can select a particular range of interest. Next come RTD or thermocouple length, the immersion length. It is the length from the thread of terminal head to the tip. We will discuss further how length is considered. Now next is process connection. First one is whether you will go for a flange type connection, then you need to provide flange dimension and number of bolts info, etc. Now second one is threaded connection, size, type of thread fitting, all you need to mention. There were the general specification you had to provide. The most important criteria you forgot, which causes failure, increase maintenance, downtime, etc. is the material of thermosheath. That protects sensor sensing element that we usually ignore. Now, because the sensor is physically inserted into the heating media, there is a thermosheath provided above the sensor to protect and withstand from heating media. Host material is selected in such a way that does not react with the processed liquid or gas. Generally, thermosheath is acrylic, stainless steel, carbon steel, cast iron is used. If there is a specific heating media, you need to provide info while procuring the sensor. The time constant of the sensor is also affected by the selection of this material. Yes, if it is low, then your PID response will be fast. It is high, your PID may be unstable or hard to tune. Using a thermosheath on the temperature sensor adds a kind of resistance and capacitance to it. As soon as sensor is inserted into process, it does not sense at all. First, outer sheath offers a resistance to the heat flow, then the sheath heats up according to its capacity. Then the temperature sensor gets its heat and sensor starts sensing. This is why the time constant of the sensor adds the delay and ultimately the response time of the control loop increases if the temperature sensor is in the PID loop. So material selection is important. If thermosheath material selection is wrong, then probably you need to replace sensor frequently. Hence plant downtime increases. So take care. Let's move to the installation techniques. Friends, any field instrument works well as long as its installation is okay. Most of the problems encountered related to installation only. Temperature showing low, not correct, all these visible response increases your maintenance issue and need replacement every time. RTD or thermocouple is specified for immersion length whenever you purchase. It is length from thread of the terminal head to the tip. Second length, that is insertion length, is important to consider. This is very important parameter in sensor installation. This means how much the sensor is inserted into the process connection. The minimum criteria is that its sensitive tip portion is immersed in the heating media. Generally, this sensitive tip portion is 60 mm in liquid, mind it, 75 mm in gas and vapor. This info is provided in OEM product catalog. And second concern is how much sensor must be inserted in process or pipe. So thumb rule is up to the center line of the pipe. Suppose you have a pipe dia of D, and now you have to take keep or insertion D by 2 of the RTD or the thermocouple sensor. So this info helps you specify length requirement of RTD and TC while procuring. The reason behind is there is a maximum temperature on the central line of the gases and liquid pipes. Heat in pipe and around the pipe walls dissipated. That is why correct reading is not available. If the sensor is to be installed in the reactor, boiler or vessel, so the length of the sensor to be keep high of its dia, and the location should be such that it does not touch any internal equipment of the reactor or vessel, like heating coil, agitator, something like that. And if the vessel is too big, then you have to take the average temperature by installing various sensor and take the average. And if insertion of the sensor is direct insertion of sensor in heating media is not possible, or the system is pressurized or something like that, due to which sensor is difficult to replace while plant is running, then thermocouple is provided in the process, in which any heat, conductive oil, etc. is filled, and then the sensor is inserted. The selection procedure of the length and material of the thermosheath will follow for the thermowell as well. The addition of the thermowell also increases the time constant of the sensor, which will affect the response time of the PID loop. So take care while selecting material. It must be highly conductive as well as it can withstand chemical reaction with heating media. Many times the sensor thermosheath is reared out due to flow of slurry, abrasive material or dust in gas due to abrasion. For this reason, the well or sensor may be inserted inclined in the direction of flow, the way you see on the screen. In this way, sensor life can be increased. If you do vertical insert, then wear tear will increase due to maximum exposure to the sensor due to media exposure, and downtime may increase. If you want the best point in the pipeline to measure temperature, it is bent portion in the pipeline. Look at the screen. In this way, a turbulence is created in the liquid or gas due to bend, by which the heating media is mixed and gives an average temperature. Also, media flow gives the least amount of abrasion due to direction of sheath and flow in the same direction. Temperature sensor for bearing temperature has a common problem of loose connection in the RTD or thermocouple terminal head. This happens because of mechanical vibration. For this, you can select the sensor with extended cable instead of terminal head. The cable length must be specified while procuring the same as per your comment. So friends, how was this video? Must comment, share with your colleagues, subordinates, and please do subscribe and touch bell icon to get mobile alert. Thank you. Bye-bye.